I wasn't going to make another video today, but there is something interesting you can do that could make some of your lives easier, mine as well, so that's enough incentive for me to share it. Yesterday I posted a how-to video on the SideQuest mobile app. If you haven't seen it yet, check it out definitely, because it makes sideloading so much easier. Today I want to show you that you can also use SideQuest within your Oculus Quest, so within VR, and I think it's so cool because the benefit of this is that it's fast than doing it via the mobile phone, and you can stay in VR forever. I'm just kidding, do not do that. Hey everyone, Cass here, and welcome to another VR tech tips. But before we continue, let me start with a disclaimer this time. Some sideloaded content may go against Facebook's terms, so make sure you're not violating anything before you sideload. Check Oculus's content guidelines for that, I'll link it below. Anyways, this is going to be a quick guide, so let's get started. But first, if you like what we do, subscribe if you haven't yet, as that's a great support. And now, join me beyond reality. Now let me tell you what you need for this. First, your Oculus Quest headset. This can be your Quest 1 or your Quest 2. Then you need a device to sideload on. This can be your PC or an Android phone. Then you also need a USB cable that you can use to connect your Quest to that device. Step 1, install SideQuest APK on the headset. Okay, the first thing to do is you need to install the SideQuest mobile app on your Oculus Quest headset. So I extracted the APK file from my phone, which I linked in the description, so you don't have to do it. You can download it from there with an Android phone or on your PC. You can then install the APK using two methods. If you have a PC, it's easy to do it via the SideQuest app. Click the install APK icon here and find the APK you downloaded, install it, and then you can move to step 2. If you want to do it via your phone, you can use the app called Bucket Jaker. I've made a tutorial on how to do that here, I'll put a link below. Step 2, turn on Wi-Fi mode on your Quest. Now you should have the SideQuest app inside your Quest, and it will look just like the mobile app, but before it works, you have to turn on Wi-Fi mode on your Quest. Unfortunately, you cannot do this within the Quest due to technical limitations, but you can do this on your PC or your Android device. On PC, you can do that easily by connecting your Quest to your PC with a USB cable. Allow all pop-ups that may show up in your Quest. Checkmark always allow so it doesn't keep on popping up. Wait until the SideQuest app says it's connected. Then click the Wi-Fi icon and click connect. Now Wi-Fi mode is on, so you can unplug your Quest and move to step 3. For those who want to do it on their phone, make sure you have watched my SideQuest phone guide, because you need the SideQuest mobile app to enable Wi-Fi mode. But once you got it, just start the SideQuest app and then connect your Quest via a USB cable to your phone, and make sure to allow all pop-ups inside the headset, as well as the pop-ups on your phone if you get them, and then wait until the SideQuest icon below turns green. Now you can click on the Wi-Fi icon at the bottom left, and then here you can click on enable Wi-Fi. Now if you didn't click always allow on the pop-ups, you may get some more pop-ups, just allow everything. Now you can unplug your Quest and move to step 3. Step 3, launch the SideQuest app in the Quest headset. You can now launch SideQuest in your Quest if you haven't yet via apps. Then from the drop down menu in unknown sources, here you can find the SideQuest app now. Click to launch it. Now there's only one more thing left to do, and that is inside the headset, click the Wi-Fi icon at the left, and here you have to fill out the local IP address of your Quest headset. But to make things easier, you can just fill out localhost here, so that automatically picks up your local IP address. But if that doesn't work for any reason, you can always find your local IP address under your Wi-Fi network advanced settings. Now click connect, and you may get some pop-ups again, you know what to do here, and then it should connect. Step 4, start sideloading. Now you can sideload all SideQuest content inside your Quest. You just click on a game using your motion controller, and then you can click install to headset, and it will start installing from within VR. And I thought this was so cool, because this makes stuff even easier. Maybe I'm lazy, but I also found that installing it this way is faster too than via the phone. And here as well, you can enable graphic settings and do all the other options within VR, and I think that is so nice if you want to play around with settings without ever taking off your headset. Now That's actually it for this guide, but I do have one extra tip. So Wi-Fi mode will actually stay enabled until you restart your Quest device. So even if you stop playing for a while, as long as you don't shut down your device, you can just reconnect later on without having to do step two again. And that makes it even easier. But it would definitely be even better if we could do the Wi-Fi enable thing without the need for a PC or phone, then SideQuest would kind of run natively on the Quest. If anyone knows how to do that, please let me know in the comments below. So I'm actually not sure whether this is intended. I'm also not sure what Facebook will think of this, but I have been using SideQuest ever since the start without trouble, so let's see. But if anything, I am your test person, so if I ever get banned by Facebook or anything, let's hope not. You are, of course, the first to know. For now, let me know what you think of this. Are you going to try it? Put it below in the comments. Now, leave me a like if you like what we do. Support us for free by watching more videos like this playlist right here. Don't forget about the giveaway. The link is below on that too. And yes, this video also has a secret code that you can fill out for more chance. Good luck, everyone. A special thanks go to all our champions, especially these patrons down below. And as always, we are